Good evening, everybody, and welcome back to Dotatalk League Day number 2. We didn't get our game for the first match. It ended up being a forfeit loss by MiTH. They couldn't find that fifth player, unfortunately. So RG Sports took the forfeit win, and here they are in the semifinals of the Dotatalk League. Looked a little shaky yesterday, to be totally honest. Let's see how they perform against MiTH Trust. One of those teams in Southeast Asia that's sort of quiet, under the radar to the average fan, but always a solid force and a team that you don't want to underestimate. MiTH Trust, really known for their split push. If you've ever watched First Departure, think MiTH Trust when you're watching them, because these two teams are quite similar. Love their split push, love their turtle, love getting multiple carries up. Whereas for RNG Sports, we haven't really seen them go late game much lately. Despite having Mushi, despite having KYXY in Ohio, players that can play a variety of heroes like Tinker, like Shadow Fiend, heroes that can scale, even Lone Druid. We've seen Orange mostly trying to win the game and force the issue quite early on.
5 seconds remaining.
With that all being said, of course, I'm LD of Beyond the Summit, so thank you all for joining me here for today's cast. And I'm a little disoriented because we've had so many technical issues on the stream, so many delays with the game, so I will try to maintain my focus, or get my focus, I should say, but I do apologize. I also want to mention, if you didn't already know, Gods is also Orange casting. If you want to watch his casts, go over to twitch.tv/beyondthesummit2, and you can watch what he's casting now. I believe he's still in the quarterfinals, currently casting Zenith versus 4Love. He will also be casting the semifinals, and then probably the third, fourth place match later today, whereas I'm going to do this match and then the grand finals. So with all that being said, let's take a look at the draft. MiTH Trust, ban out the Keeper of the Light, ban the Mag. Standard bans really from both teams. Probably the four most standard bans in the current pool, especially in Asia, I should say. In Europe, you'd see a Wisp ban here, maybe potentially something like a Gyrocopter ban against certain teams, but pretty much as standard as you can get for Asia. Occasionally Lone Druid in China will get the ban, but Leicester, the first pick for MiTH Trust, so this is a team that's favored heroes like Nature's Prophet, Naga Siren, for Lakels, occasionally an Anti-Mage, but they're going to do something a little bit different this game. Pick up the Lifestealer, pick up the Queen of Pain, probably going to be handled by Abba, as he is normally their solo mid player. We'll see what the rest of the team does from here, but I mean, this is a strong lineup for just diving heroes in the mid game with the Lifestealer who can infest the side Queen of Pain. You have a lot of burst damage. Obviously, Lone Druid and Lifestealer are both good against each other. Lifestealer is good against Lone Druid because obviously Feast is fantastic against naturally tanky heroes, but at the same time, Lone Druid can be very potent versus the Lifestealer because Entangle, of course, goes through that rage. So it's a kind of a two-way street between these two carries. Won't come down to that matchup slowly, but it's something to keep in mind. As for Orange, have not picked up that solo mid yet,
10 seconds
and I'm curious what they're going to pair up here. The Shadow Demon Lone Druid opening, they get that strong support who can counter the Lifestealer in the Shadow Demon with the Demonic Purge. This lineup looks pretty well-rounded for Orange so far. Same for MiTH. They go back for the Rubik, so they get that support. They have a variety of ways to play this game. They can split push with Lifestealer, Queen of Pain, but they have more of a ganking option than what we normally see out of MiTH Trust. So I'm curious how they're going to develop this draft the rest of the way. And I'm wondering how Orange is going to respond. Are they still going to keep on trying to force the fights and break the base early? Almost a la LGDN. No, they're not. They go back for the TA. They're going to play a little more gank-oriented themselves. They're going to spread this map as well. And they get in the TA a hero that can do well against Queen of Pain. Even after Refractions being nerfed, it's still a matchup the TA can win if you play it well. I have seen TAs just absolutely destroy this matchup out of the Asian region. We'll see if that's going to be the case this game. But certainly is a possibility. So expecting to see that TA versus Queen of Pain matchup mid. Of course, TA is a pretty good hero against the MiTH Trust lineup because they are lacking in damage over time. Sure, they do have Shadow Strike, but that's hardly reliable. It only ticks every few seconds. Enough to quickly bring down the Refraction charges in the mid game. And for Orange, I'm liking their lineup so far. A little bit more well-rounded, not quite as focused on just ending the game at that 20 to 25 minute mark, maybe 25 to 30, but instead getting a lineup that will scale better. Multiple carries, a support that's strong later on. The Chen will be banned, though. That's the downside to going this way with the draft is, of course, Extinct won't be playing Chen. We've seen him playing here. I think the last time I saw him not playing Chen, he was playing a Rubick, and that was before Net actually joined the team. So I wonder what he'll get his hands on this game. As for Orange, as far as the laning possibilities, it's pretty much got to be the TA going mid. The Lone Druid could be the offlaner for KYXY, meaning Ohio's likely to be on the TA. KYXY is likely to be on the Lone Druid. We don't have Mushi's heroes yet. For him, We're thinking something with the Shadow Demon, potentially a hero like Anti-Mage, like Faceless Void. Faceless Void is actually pretty damn strong against Mythtrust lineup. Rubick can steal Chronosphere, but that being said, of course, you're up against the Lifestar, and you're up against the Queen of Pain. Rage will be useless against Chronosphere. You can't infest anything while you're inside of the Chrono, obviously. And Queen of Pain, well, that Blink ability won't be able to help you. MiTH, though, in an interesting ban, they're actually going to get rid of the Lion with his 4-second Hex when it's maxed. Not a hero we see much of, but if they're planning a passive early game, which it seems they might be, then banning a strong mid-game support that needs a lot of levels like Lion makes a lot of sense. So this suggests that most likely Mythtrust isn't going to go aggressive tri-lane. They could. They certainly could, but with this kind of a ban, Lion's not a strong hero in the 3v3 matchup. So if you ban a hero like Lion, then you're basically saying, we don't really plan to be aggressive, so we don't want you to get a hero that will benefit from the lack of aggression.
10 seconds.
So an interesting ban from them. Enigma, the response from Orange. So actually a hero that I thought Orange maybe would run occasionally, but not going to be the case here. Juggernaut, what is going on with this draft? There must be some Orange scrimmages that I have just not seen, because I think they've run the Juggernaut a grand total of one time. That wasn't even Orange. That was Burning playing for DK. Yeah, I have not seen them run Juggernaut at all. Obviously, the Healing Ward has some synergy with their lineup, just because Lone Druid's a strong pusher and Healing Ward is a great pushing ability. You can run a tri-lane with the Juggernaut, the Shadow Demon, but Jug's not really that good against Queen of Pain. He's okay against Lifestealer. Sure, Omni Slash will go through Rage, but it's not really that much damage. So I find this third ban really curious. Orange, a little bit more straightforward. They're going to ban the Darkseer. They see MiTH doesn't have that offlaner, and they also most likely, like I have, just don't expect MiTH to go aggressive after banning a hero like Lion.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
What's it gonna be, MiTH? Lashrak the choice. Interesting. So Rubick plus Lashrak gives them a hero in Lashrak who has Edict, a great way to deal with Templar Assassin's Refraction in the mid game. If the Lashrak goes that route, Lightning build has been the preferred build generally in Asia, especially in China, simply because of its anti-pushing potential. We'll see what he goes for, but we're going Face Rush, baby. RNG Sports says, we are going to take the fight to you. They pick up the Bounty Hunter, so it does shift our lanes a little bit. It looks like it'll most likely be a Mushi one-position Lone Druid playing in that safe lane with an off-lane Bounty Hunter and then a TA heading mid. So three strong mid-game semi-carries, potentially hard carries in the case of Lone Druid especially. And another way to deal with Lifestealer, because that track does go through Rage if you cast it after the Rage. Rage, of course, does remove it. And then you can kite him quite effectively. You can also chase a hero like Queen of Pain down with the Psionic Traps and Track and Entangle. And that bear will be moving fast as lightning with that additional move speed. So we will see. But an interesting choice from Orange. And MiTH says, hey, we're going to get our third carry. So they go back for the Naga Siren. Can be run in an aggressive tri-lane, so maybe they are looking to get aggressive. Maybe they're planning to run the Lifestealer 1v1 versus the Bounty Hunter. Very odd to see them ban a hero like Lion. I guess he's strong against the illusions of Naga. You can mana drain them or hex them to instantly dispel an illusion, but still, I mean, that's, you really don't want to be blowing an ability like Hex on a Naga illusion, and rarely do you actually get to cast Mana Drain in a team fight without actually being punished for it, because you have to be fairly close to a unit to do so. Very odd to see this Lion ban if they are planning to go aggressive, but, well, let's see what they go. The Shadow Shaman, the final choice for Orange. So they go back for some strong disables of their own, and a hero who kind of fills in a pinch that same role as the Lion. Of course, giving you that Hex, giving you that way to basically burst a hero like Queen of Pain down before she can blink away. And as expected, well, it is going to be Abba on that Queen of Pain. So he'll be heading mid. He will be playing against Mushi because Ohio is playing the Lone Druid. RNG Sports, like I said yesterday, did not really have the most solid performances. And it seems Mushi has said, guys, I'm going mid. I'm going to show you guys how to play that role. No. Oh, are they going to switch? That's the only question. Maybe they're going to do a little switcheroo here and try and pull a fast one on Mythtrust, but something Mushi is known for in all his teams. He does tend to switch roles fairly frequently if things aren't going well. Occasionally he'll kind of take a break from playing and start coaching a little bit, sort of stepping back from playing on the day-to-day as a competitive player. So nothing too surprising there. Uh, So it looks like stream has been relatively stable. Glad to see that. Let me click and introduce the teams, though. On the side of MiTH Trust, we have SD playing the Rubick. TNK on the Lifestealer. R5, R5 on the Shrek. So SD and R5, R5. Everybody, MiTH Trust has really been a stable team. I think they've been using this roster since well before the International 2, like at least 4 or 5 months before it. This lineup has been together longer than almost anyone in the world as far as teams that are either top professional teams, or in the case of MiTH Trust, they've sort of been like right on the border between being a true top team and a team that's kind of the next step down. But especially as of late, we haven't seen great results from them, but still the same lineup. This is a little bit of a switch for them, though. They're giving Abba the Rubick. He does normally go solo mid for the team. Now they're swapping again, and they're confusing the absolute crap out of me. Orange is not swapping, however. Okay, let's try this again. Maybe they've settled. Okay. It's not going to be Lakels on the Naga. Interesting. Oh, is Orange swapping? Maybe I missed it. Oh, every team is just constantly keeping an eye on this. Of course, it's a really common thing nowadays. I actually think that it's kind of annoying, to be honest, as a caster. I hate it. Okay, they've swapped back. These are the expected lanes, the expected roles. So we have Lakels on his hard carry Naga. I would say his signature hero above all others. We have seen him play heroes like Morphling in the past, but as of late, it's really been this Naga Siren he prefers. TNK playing the Lifestealer. SD on the Rubick. R5 R5 on the Shrek. So they're not going aggressive, which is what I thought they would do. It looks like they're going to jungle the Lifestealer. Quelling Blade and the Stout Shield, the starting items. He can just sit him in that offlane, but he's probably not going to CS too much. Even 1v1 against a hero like Lone Journey will struggle a lot. Over on the side of RNG Sports, we are going to have Net on the Shadow Demon. Ohio on the Lone Druid. So it is a switch as expected. Or not as expected, but as I was talking about earlier. Extinct on the Shadow Shaman. It will be Mushi going mid as the TA, rushing the bottle. Going back to something that we saw a lot from him in the Beyond the Summit World Tour. And then, of course, at the International 2, we are seeing his Quita Pain, his TA going mid almost every game for Orange Esports. So, Ohio being pushed more into sort of that role that we saw from Yamate before Orange made their roster changes. Last but not least, KYXY on the Bounty Hunter. So, did I finish introducing MiTH? I think I did. Yeah, R5, R5 on the Lashrak, and SD on the Rubick. I think that should cover it. So, with all that being said, the game is finally underway. If you're just tuning in, the format for the semifinals is a best out of one, meaning that if you lose, you go home. $1,000 in hardware prizes at stake for here at the Dotatalk League. Of course, you're watching this coverage on Beyond the Summit. And as I mentioned earlier, my partner in crime, Gods, is going to be doing some casting of his own. It's currently underway on Beyond the Summit 2, twitch.tv/BeyondTheSummit2, if you want to check that out. I think he just got done with Zenith versus For Love, actually. Didn't see who won that one, but should be interesting. So for the mid lane, Mushi getting an interesting creep block here, but Abba's gotten the range creep out in front, so we'll see. This lane probably going to push heavily in favor of Abba. He'll be on the high ground, as his range creep is the first one to fall. Even though it looks like Mushi's push is better. Actually, it looks like he wants to push. He's going to aggro the creeps into the tower, so some interesting decision-making here. He gets the creeps even further up on the hill, but that allows Abba to get more aggressive. Mushi takes meld at level 1 and is able to meld dodge that Shadow Strike. Some really nice individual play just off the bat from him. This makes Shadow Strike very ineffective, and meld is still the same amount of cost it always was. It's only 50. Meanwhile, on the bear is getting ganked in the bottom lane, attempting those pulling shenanigans. It's already done its work, though. This is sort of the new way to deal with Lone Druid in the offlane. You don't actually try to pull the wave. You just keep the creeps back so that you get a huge wave. Your creeps die at their tower, and then it will push. KYXY, of course, that Lone Druid bear actually being used by Ohio in the top lane. He can resummon it soon. He doesn't really need it as he's in the safe lane, so a nice little adjustment from him. Seems like Orange off to a good start so far. Lone Druid CSing well. TA for Mushi CSing really well. All the cores aside from the Bounty Hunter getting a lot of farm, and Bounty's going to start getting experience now because KYXY, I assume he was the one micro in the bear. It could have potentially been Ohio, but more logical for it to be KYXY, as that would be a lot of work for Ohio. He'd have to basically be playing StarCraft there, or a miniature version. KYXY, the wave now at his tower. MiTH can push it though. They have Edict. Of course, that Blofilling Bounty Hunter, not very good at stopping the pushes. They're actually diving him. They've already dropped the Sentry Ward. This is an expensive push for them. Deploying two Sentry Wards immediately means once these wear off in 2 minutes, if they haven't used them to get two towers, get a big advantage, then they won't have them at that point. They won't have any way to keep them out without buying more, and sentries are very expensive. They are still 200 gold, unlike the new observers, which should get reduced a little bit. So, overall, as far as the trades go, I would say pretty even trades. It's really going to come down to the mid game, but the big thing for me is that right now, we are seeing TA just kind of get a lot out of this middle lane, more than other Templar Assassin players have from recent games I've cast. I mean, in theory, I think TA should have a decent time in the matchup, just because you can Melch dot Shadow Strike, and without Shadow Strike, there's really no way to bring her down early. And Lekkels isn't getting as much CS. They're getting a lot more out of their offlane. It's a jungle lifestealer. So that's really the big difference is Mushi's getting a little more than you'd expect mid. But the bigger thing is, well, it's a lifestealer who's trying to jungle. And he's just not that efficient as a jungler. You can see KYXY is already level 3. He's going to start getting more. They did get that tier 1 bottom early. Lekkels picked up the last hit. But Ohio is just absolutely free farming. And because of the way the Bounty Hunter disrupted the creep aggro with the Lone Druid Bear, and caused the lane to push, Lekkels was hitting under the enemy tower. That's why his CS is so much lower than Ohio. Whereas for Ohio, he's been doing a pretty good job of controlling this lane. You can see this tower has yet to take a single point of damage. KYXY, he wasn't even pulled either, so they didn't invest a whole lot in this bounty hunter. They're actually rotating in towards mid, looking to go. This is going to be a 4-hero gank on Mushi middle lane. Can they bring him down? They start with the open wounds. They've got that telekinesis lift as well as the dust. Mushi's going to man up, try to fight his way out of this one. Now he's lifted. Now he's stunned. Mushi is dead. Down he goes. 4 heroes invested for that kill, as well as your jungle life, so they're not farming during that time, but they do get it. They may go for the tier 1 now. You on the bottom lane, KYXY continue to see us net and extinct, content to do some pulling and farming of their own. Actually not really getting that much out of the pulls just yet. Only level 2 on both heroes, whereas we look at R5 and SD, they got the tier 1 bottom. They've journeyed all the way towards mid, they've gone for first blood, and they're going on Mushi again. Nope. I think it's a little far to dive, and they're not going to go. But the tower's going to fall. The Glyph was already used bottom earlier. Last hit by Abba. So even though he wasn't really dominating this middle lane, with the help of his team, suddenly he's back in business. He's got that level 5 up, a little bit underleveled compared to if he's just sitting in the lane by himself, but still in pretty good shape. Mushi, of course, slowed down by that death. So Ohio hitting level 6 soon. What is he going to go for? It looks like he may be rushing something. I don't think we'll see the Midas from him. This is a good game, I feel, to split push. Get that Radiance because you're up against the lineup in Myth that can split push quite effectively. And Orange don't really have a 5-man lineup. They went for TA as well as Bounty Hunter. These are heroes that are best at spreading the map and then finding kills in sort of the seams that are created by that split push. So most likely, we'll see something like the Radiance build from him in kind of a more late-game-oriented style. After two towers fall, about a 2k gold lead and a 750 gold or experience lead for the Dire. So all things being considered, Orange slightly ahead in experience, and Myth basically ahead in tower gold. Obviously, they've got the map control advantage, but the question is going to be, what can they turn that into? They did delay the Rubik 6 a bit with all the earlier roaming. He's only level 3 at 5 minutes in, whereas Extinct is getting very close to level 4. Pretty slow start to this game. We had one kill, but that's really it. TNK picking up the Gloves of Haste, looking like he's going Midas. Doesn't have to be, obviously. Can be Power Trades, can be Armlet, can be a lot of things. But normally when you start with Gloves that early, you'd expect something like a Hanamitis. He's gonna TP towards top. Can easily be killed here, though. Lifestealer can die. He doesn't have Infest yet. He's only got regular boots. They're not upgraded to phase. If he gets entangled at the right moment, they can bring him down. But the question is gonna be, how much will they actually commit to killing him, or do they just want to focus on farming their supports? Obviously, Shadow Shaman and Shadow Demon, very, very level dependent. Mid lane, in they go. Trying to get this killed. Abba, he's already used the blink. The disruption actually buying time for that blink to cool down. He may escape. No, I'm not sure. Mushi trying to get in range. One more auto attack. We'll pick up the kill. So they push that middle lane, and then Abba, because the tier 1's down, is forced to farm past the river. And mid, you can't mid pull anymore, so there's no way to draw the lane back like there is in a side lane. Abba really should have just been farming the neutrals, maybe preparing for that 6-minute rune, but gets caught out of position mid. Gets picked off, an important kill for Orange, and they didn't really waste that much in getting that kill. Bounty Hunter almost hitting 6 off of that. The lane was a bit farther back at that point anyway, so a good time for him to gank. Meanwhile, the rotation comes in top from Myth Trust. Will they find an opening here? TNK is level 5, but Ohio's 6 with his ultimate up. Not a hero you want to go on with a level 3 Lashrak. Even with Queen of Pain ult, bursting him down is going to be nigh impossible. You want to find the squishy heroes. Are they going to try for the Lone Druid? They are. They're starting with the open wounds. He's so damn tanky. Maybe they'll have enough. There's no backup in sight. I guess the supports don't have TP scrolls. Ohio's taking tons of damage. Probably saying, where the hell is my team? His team is not here. Mushi's heading back to base. Just completed his phase, but he's been shut down early. And Net was out of position to actually disrupt him there. KYXY, no TP on him. What a great time to go for MiTH. I mean, normally you dive a lone druid like that. The fight can be turned around, but Orange don't have a hero like a Mag, a Panda, a Tidehunter, some big team fight specialist, even a Beastmaster, who could TP in and punish that kind of a dive. And to make matters worse, they did not have TPs on either of their solos. So well played by MiTH, and that's now two solos for Orange who both died. Naga's starting to pull ahead. Laquelle's doing his thing. If I know my Laquelle's, he'll go Radiance. He'll angle for late game. Maybe he'll start with something like a Linket Sphere first, but generally Laquelle's does prefer the farming-oriented split push build for himself. And that was also a really important kill in Ohio because he is saving his gold. It looks like he is going to be going for that Radiance. If he wanted to go something else, he could have started buying the components now. So if he's not going Radiance, then it's a bit of an inefficient way to itemize the hero. Mushi phase boots up, bottle up, heading towards the bottom rune. Invis picked up by him. Mushi did start to catch up a bit, but still, when you look at the tower gold, I mean, they're up by almost three towers worth of gold. They only have two, so they're actually out farming now because they have the two kills and the first blood. They're down on experience, but it's very insignificant. All things considered for MiTH, considering how many carries they have and how hard their lineup scales just from farming, things are going well for them. There's smoke behind Laquelle's. They're looking to go here on Ohio. Can they get the lift? Justin ranges SD, throws him back. Where's that split earth? Not gonna be there. Not gonna be there. Now it's there. Finally throws it out. Ohio will die again, and Orange just seemed totally bewildered. They rotate the low druid towards bottom lane, I guess wanting the bounty hunter to have a chance to roam and let the supports get the experience and gold top, which makes sense considering how level dependent their supports are. But the issue is there's no lane wards for the lone druid. He has no, sure they were smoked, but you could at least see the aggression potentially depending on where they smoke or just have more vision around the map and say, hey, we see a lot of empty space. Where are those supports? But no vision for him. Another death for a core. That's three deaths on the cores of Orange. And Bounty Hunter is the one who's not dying, but he's a Bounty Hunter. Later on in the game, MiTH have a strong five-man lineup. They can split push, they can force the fights, and Bounty doesn't really excel in those engagements. He's all about just finding these easy pickoffs on squishy supports, ideally while they're isolated. And the other question is going to be, can they kill Laquelle's? They really need the Shadow Shaman Hex to do it. Without that Hex, there just doesn't seem to be any way for them to find the kills. And still not level 6, 10 minutes in. There's your open wounds top lane. Ohio taking some damage, getting chopped away, dropping low. Where the hell is the backup for Ohio? Oh my goodness, the third death for him. And just not getting any support, no lane wards, just defensive jungle wards up right now. That's three deaths on your lone druid who was CSing like a boss. Ohio had great farm. I mean, you could argue that it's team miscommunication. I'm not saying it's necessarily the support's fault, but if you're Orange, you gotta protect your lone druid better than this. Heroes like TA and Bounty Hunter, they didn't have a fast enough start that they can just carry the game without some help. If TA jumps into this fight, she's eating edict damage. Those refraction charges aren't going to be long for this world. Mushi has gone Bracer, a sign of the times. Remember, this is the best out of one. Orange can't afford to mess around. If they lose this game, if they drop this game, they are out of the tournament. And it's your semifinals. The grand finals will be a best out of three, but until we get there, Orange got to tighten the ship. Ohio's not gone bottom. Where is he gonna farm? If I'm Ohio, like, they're in my head at this point. You know, you try to be patient and calm, but a hero like Lone Druid dying three times in the course of 11 minutes, and you're pretty much the only hero on your team dying, that is more or less a disaster. This is a one position safe lane Lone Druid who got the protection of two supports in the laning stage. They do have Shadow Shaman level 5. Still no ultimate on Extinct. Still no Shadow Shaman wards. We're 11 minutes in. And that's a crucial level for Orange, because at least they can, that's one of their best teamfight abilities. In fact, it's probably the best teamfight ability they have, unless you want to count something like Track, which is okay in teamfights, but not that great. I'm very worried for Orange right now. They're suddenly down by 7,500 gold. Here comes the gank bottom lane. They start with the Naganet. The supports are here, but finally a disruption is in play, and that may be enough to let Ohio live, or maybe not. They pull him back in, but just a simple disruption, even after the slow start, is enough. Now the Naga sleep. Where's the TP out? Laquelle's will go for it. He's going to block off the retreat path. TP's way to safety. A massive cock block for MiTH, and then they're just going to run away. So Orange thwarted. Meanwhile, top lane, Lifestealer pushing. Did go for the treads, now going back for the armlet. So going for the mid game, they have a hero like Naga who can scale quite well late with the right items, can really flash farm, and Orange is not farming. But this is what I was talking about earlier. You just have that Shadow Demon in position to disrupt the Lone Druid, and he won't die. If he's in the right spot, if they know the gank's coming and they're prepared, Lone Druid will not die unless they commit 5 heroes and throw every ability at you. And if they do that, then you should be able to punish them for their tower dive. So finally having the Shadow Demon in position, even after a few failed ganks, or a few successful ganks at a bit of a deficit, they're able to keep Ohio alive for once. And now he can see us. He's up to 2k gold. Could still get a relic at a reasonable time for an offlane Lone Druid, but it is going to be late for a safe laner. No question about that. Mikkels, will he go for his signature Radiance? Will he go for split push? Normally that's what we see. And with this kind of farm, does seem like a solid game for it. They're going to go again. Really nice movement for MiTH supports this game. SD and R5 have been setting the tempo, creating the openings, and doing it on a combo that has not been as picked as much lately in Southeast Asia. We've seen a lot more of heroes like Sand King. They want to go mid on Abba. They are smoked up. They need a Hex to start. A Hex and then a Shackle. That's the only way to kill Abba. Unless, say, they keep blinks into them, and then they could just track him and auto-attack him down. But he's going to head top. They want to get Ohio again. He has a TP. They don't actually avoid to cancel this TP, though. So most likely, if he's smart, he could just TP away. With the armlet, he's going to do it immediately. There's a Queen of Pain. Has the ult. Not going to be in time. So a quick reaction from Ohio will save his life. A nice calm under pressure there from the gentle giant, as they call him. For anyone who doesn't know, Ohio is quite tall. From what I gather, up there, GG, almost GG Net God's height, if not quite that tall, but he is the gentle giant of RNG sports. Don't anger the giant, though. We saw what happened when the rest of the world did that to America in World War II. You awaken the sleeping giant. He may bite, he may smack, he may claw. Best to just kill him in his sleep. They tried to do it there in Ohio, but they couldn't. Anyway, Mushi drums up for him. Dust as well, throwing it out, but he may man up, get a kill here. Abba throws out the ult, just gets exploded by Mushi, so that early drums absolutely paying off, giving him that extra survivability he needed. And for MiTH, just underestimating the power of Refraction. They do have Edict, they do have Shadow Strike, but it takes a little bit of time to actually chew through, and there were creeps there. So unfortunately, the Edict not immediately eliminated. So Mushi dodges the bullet, and the first failed gank I think we've seen all game for MiTH Trust. Still, Lakels is farming up to 3k gold. He, at this rate, I think he'll have the relic before the Lone Druid. In fact, he's ahead. TNK is going to TP out, and there's just no way to stop it. That cheeky lifestealer. Such a pain in the arse to play against. Abba's going to TP immediately back towards mid. Let's see what he does. TP's in. He's going Orchid, so a pretty smart choice this game. You're up against supports that are devastating if they're left unattended. Shadow Demon and the Shadow Shaman, they can obviously extend the fights, turn it around with multiple Hexes, multiple Shackles. So versus them, Orchid's going to be powerful. And if you look at Arnt, they don't have many true stuns. There's one hero that can just lock you down. That's the Shadow Shaman. So as long as you either burst him or just silence him, he's not going to be an issue. And no matter what, if as long as you don't blow your blink foolishly, you should be able to escape. Maybe if you get unluckily entangled, but aside from that, should be absolutely okay. I still favor the pace of the game heavily for MiTH. I mean, they have the lineup with the better 5-man late game, assuming that Mushi doesn't get outrageously farmed, and he's not really getting that much CS, and the Lone Druid's not either. Arnt's lineup much more equipped to find those kills around the map. MiTH's lineup stronger in the direct clashes. They have very tanky carries, and Arnt is lacking on the true disables to bring them down. Orange also does not have a natural Hex carrier. Sure, they have the built-in Shadow Shaman Hex, but that's really it. And of course, if he's silenced, he ain't hexing you. That's for damn sure. It's big rotation towards the top side of the map. Ohio continue to farm. They're finally protecting him. They're actually smoke behind him. Extinct's gonna dispel. That smoke will be dispelled because Abba walks up the ramp. They're gonna start with the lift on the Lone Druid. He's got some backup though. Hello, Arn says, we're here. Trap is baited. Trap is set. They get one kill. Now the lifesteal giving chase onto Ohio. Split Earth is gonna cancel that. They may yet kill him again. They will. The relic even further delayed. And in fact, all the while, guess who's farming? Guess who hasn't been killed yet this game? It's Lakels. He's sitting on a kill, zero assist. This is how Lakels wins games. Very much like Miracle from First Departure. Split pushing while his team fights 4v1 or 4v5. Basically, you guys just take the fight to them, give me a good start, and I will repay it back in spades later on. That's sort of MiTH Trust Dota for you. And right now, it's looking decent for them. Lakels has the relic. The Lone Druid, what is that? His fourth death of the game, I believe. Four deaths, and that time they were even protecting him. But unfortunately, he slipped away to the north, and just the team wasn't there to back him up. Now they're going to wait on net. Top lane. There is no Demonic Purge yet. Actually, there is. Net's just not using it. He's baiting this one. He could throw out the Purge now, but not going to waste it because he doesn't have any backup. So instead, he just sits back at the tower. Orchid's coming, though. Quarterstaff is up. That second Oblivion Staff, not far off. Relic now complete on Lakel. 17 minutes in. Not the fastest Relic in the world. Only 100 CS, which we saw some players yesterday who had 108. So I think we saw Miracle with like 120. 120 plus CS around this point on his anti-mage, but still really solid farm, and you got to consider he's a Naga. He's not a hero who can just rush a Battle Fury and blink from camp to camp. Naga can farm quite efficiently with the mirror image spam, as well as just using Riptide, microing one illusion each camp and then blowing them up, but not going to do it quite as quickly. Now the illusion's deployed in the lane. The push continues from Lakels. Constant pressure there. Lifestealer mans up onto Extinct. Is tracked. That is helping him to survive. In comes an angry Mushi, race car style. There's your infest. Not for long, they say. Not for long. Now the purge. Queen of Pain is here. I think a smoke was just dropped and doesn't seem like it accomplishes this too much. Interesting arm lithography from TNK. Dropping low. Not dead yet. Abba may fall. Blinks away. Still they chase. Mushi lifted. Drop back into R5. He says, fine, I'll kill him instead. Then I'll kill SD. Here he goes with the big track kills. They're finding the pickoffs. They're finding the openings. It all started from the overextension of the Lifestealer in the enemy jungle. Spotted out, I believe, by the Mushi trap right here. Not 100% sure, but I think that's how they saw him. Still, they haven't killed the Kells, and now the Radiance is online. Well, once he buys it, it will be online. Mushi's gone back for the Yasha. So, just skipping the Blink Dagger, and I think it's a great choice. There's so many ways to make that Blink useless. There's damage over time spells for the Queen of Pain. There's the net from the Naga. Instead, gonna go for your Mansa style, which you can use to get out of open wounds. It no longer removes the net, even though it did remove the Naga and Snare in Dota 1. But unfortunately, much to my chagrin, I found out the hard way. That is not the case in Dota 2. You can probably imagine my frustration. That was actually a while ago that I found that out, and well, I guess it was an intentional change and sort of an engine mechanic limitation in Dota 1. It did kind of make the Ensnare useless in the mid-game, if you can just manta out of it. Ohio, lurking bottom lane. Queen of Pain has that fresh Orchid up. This will allow them to burst him down quickly. Can they find yet another kill? The Invisorant's not wearing off yet. In comes Net towards the bottom lane, but he's going to be too late. This is not going to be enough, I feel. There's your Orchid. Big damage being done. They throw him back in. TNK still has Rage. He's going to pop it now, and the Demon Edge being up means Ohio will die yet again. SD steals the Battle Cry. Not what he was hoping for, but he's gonna battle cry away.
Radiance Courier has been killed.
Oh no. Oh no! What the hell? KYXY hunts the Radiant Courier all the way to the base and picks it off. That is just a ridiculous spot to kill the Courier. Nature's Prophet, yeah, you can see him do that all the time, but here, like, Bounty Hunter, not really what you expect.
Top tower is under
nice attack. Job by KYXY actually hunting that down. In terms of gold, how are we doing, guys? Little over 8k lead right now for MiTH, a 2k experience lead, which is basically nothing. But now they have the Orchid up on Abba, which means they can burst anyone who's alone with the Lifestealer, as well as the Silence combo. Mushi might be hard, though, since he's Refraction up, but it's actually down. He tries to TP out. He will not escape. Another death for a core on Orange. And MiTH Trust just showing a nice teamwork ethic through this mid-game. They started with the good roams for the two supports, but they've kept the pressure up, and now we're going to see Lakels constantly splitting those illusions, sending them to the enemy camps or his own, farming them. You can see these actually took some Radiance as well as Riptide damage. You can basically keep a lane pushed and farm the enemy jungle constantly, and if they ever go on you, you just sleep. The only way you die is if they entangle you, or not entangle you, but hex you, but too late. Lakels just going to ult and TP out. He's getting close to level 16. Oh, he TP'd back to base. That's a blunder. Wanted to TP bottom, but just panicked and double-clicked the TP there. Kind of understandable. Still, it will slow down his farming a bit. One thing Orange maybe could have done this game if they had more map control was just go for Roche. They have the Templar Assassin. I'm sure if Winter's Cassidy would have been talking about it for the past 20 minutes, but you have Tia, you have Meld, and you have Lone Druid who can tank. We can do some good damage. Now has the Relic up, but really slipping behind the Naga, who is about, what are we looking at, like 2k? No, even more, 4k ahead. Because she also went for a lot of cheap items first. The Soul Ring, the Basilius, and the Tranquil Boots. They're going to find SD mid lane, though. That's a 3-hero track kill. I believe Mushu was in range for that track hold, and now pops a Drum Charge, giving chase, then backing off. They're not going to commit just yet. the Roche Pit, TP out from R5, KYXY, looming over the horizon, lurking the distance. Now Laquelle's going to send those illusions in again, and we should see a nice little split from him. Two illusions head here, but there's nothing you can Radiance Burn. So instead, one illusion will go here, and he'll pop the Riptide once he gets in range of every single camp. We'll probably see it once he gets to the lane, actually. Yep, Riptide's right now, and this is what I mean with the Naga, is it's actually a very potent farmer if you get this amount of farm. Won't scale as well as with the items as other heroes, but still can be quite a devastating force. They do know Naga sleeps on cooldown, so Laquelle needs to get the hell out. It's not level 16 yet, but SD is here. Dust catches KYXY. He was spotted at this ward, and now they net him. They want to bring him down. He's riptided. He will escape barely. By the tip of his chinny chin chin, he'll get away. Everything he had was needed for that escape. But they're on the hunt. Abba's here, blinks in, drops the Orchid on Mushi. Now the slow tries to TP out. They don't actually have a basher yet on the Lifestealer, so he will escape in the end. The supports come in, but Abba says, fine, I'll kill you instead. And because Mushi TP'd away, he's not available to help. There is a Queen of Pain ult. Will she throw it? She's also got a gem. Got to be careful about blinking on Extinct. Doesn't want to actually get Hexed. Now the Hex is pulled down. Could look to drop it. Hexes Abba, but dies first to the Lashrak Lightning and the Shadow Demon. The two supports just instantly murdered in the midst of the fight. Still, Laquelle's farming the jungle has now finally arrived with his hero. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Ohio tries to split push, but just doesn't have the items to really do it effectively. Still, the fight continues. The gem on the floor. Queen of Pain loses her life, but Laquelle's has now arrived. Could look for a net here on KYXY. They're going to get an additional kill, and they recover the gem. Lost Laquelle's, or not Laquelle's, but Abba, which is a pretty big loss, all things considered. Still, the overall of a fight definitely favoring MiTH. We can see that in the gold graph. Still increasing a bit, even with track gold going the way of orange here and there. There was a buyback, in fact, from the Queen of Pain. Abba says, let's fight right now. Buyback from the Bounty Hunter in response. TPing in top. TNK's on the run. Doesn't have a TP scroll, so they might look to go on him. SD's going to throw the bear up in the air. Just probably throwing his own life away. No, maybe they're going to fight. The whole team has arrived on the back lines. It's Mushi. Comes in. Picks up the Lashrak, but Abba is here with the Orchid. And once again, Mushi will die. The gem on the ground. It looks like the Rubick and Lashrak are the two down right now for MiTH. So they don't have their supports, but they need to deal with this Lifestar. And they're not doing so yet. He gets yet another kill. Still chasing Laquelle's, who doesn't have Song of the Siren, will die, and finally he'll fall. Buyback from Laquelle's. That's got to be four or five buybacks in this fight. Now the blink onto KYXY, who's silenced, now disrupted, trying to live. I don't think anybody picked up the gem. KYXY, one more auto attack will bring him down. The armlet toggles from TK to keep him alive. The gem is still on the floor top. Nobody ever picked it up in the midst of that chaos. That was a lot of buybacks, though. Let's tally the bodies, guys. Buyback from Naga, buyback from Queen of Pain, and the Bounty Hunter. So double buyback on the MiTH Trust cores. They don't have Naga sleep. It's cooldown in 30 seconds. The Naga illusions being used to push in mid with the Radiance as well as the Riptide. And now we're going to see a Roche attempt. And Orange know about this, but the question is, can they actually stop it? Even just getting here in time is going to be tough. They're going to try for it, though. They can maybe go for... At least some Radiance Burn to start this off. It's going to be fairly close. In they go, looking for the pit. The Roach is about to fall. Are they going to find the opening? Mushi lurking. Mushi waiting. Starts to go to work. Look at those huge meld auto attacks. The big refraction damage. Bringing down three. And that's the Aegis pop. Aegis expanded. Infest inside of Laquelle's. But Laquelle's is trapped. Laquelle's is going to die. This is going to be four heroes dead. And an Aegis expanded. Orange Esports get there just in the nick of time. Mushi landed probably three or four full damage, one meld strike, and then three or four just refraction activated auto attacks with a Yasha. That hurts. That really hurts. And the gold graph is going to plummet as there were some track kills in that fight. Experience also plummeting. Orange on a tear. What a catastrophic engagement for MiTH. You know, they had a good fight top. It was a 3-for-1 or a 2-for-3, I think, in the end. But then they force the issue after the double buyback. That means they can't have those cores come back into the fight. They're going to go now. Mushi says one hit, one kill. Down SD will go. The tower under siege, just chopping away on these creeps. And all of the momentum, just MiTH looks deflated. It's like a balloon that just got popped. No helium left for now. The tower deny attempted. Even that going the way of Mushi. Orange definitely not with as strong of a teamfighter five-man, but just finding these smaller scale engagements. That Roche clash was pretty much a small scale engagement, and the Naga had sleep, but was hexed when she wanted to use it. Wasn't able to escape. Just too committed to that Roche in the end. Could have played it safe, pushed out the lanes, looked for a better opportunity, but they forced the issue, and they paid in spades. I mean, talk about an expensive fight. When it's all said and done, that's about a 4-5k gold dip. Lekkels has not progressed. He had that Radiance. Well, he's got the Vitality Booster, so he's progressed a bit. But a long way off from getting truly fat. Where's the Lone Druid? Radiance up for Ohio. Let's see what else he has. On the bear, Plate Mail and Hyperstone. No boots yet, but I assume we'll see those at some point. The Assault Caress is coming soon. Ohio's really clawing his way back into this game. If we look at net worth, Mushi's actually in the lead. He's got a BKB up. He's going to be very hard to deal with in these fights. There is a Naga net. Obviously, that can ultimate place through the BKB. There's no way for him to deal with that. But that also means it's going to be hard to kill him. Naga does some okay physical damage, but she really doesn't hit that hard until she gets an item like Diffusal Blade, ideally a Butterfly. And of course, BKB is going to block any sort of Mono Burn damage. So they have Lifestealer, in theory, a decent... Well, actually not in theory. He's got an MKB. Okay. He hits like a truck. He can kill Mushi, but the rest of them, not going to be able to do it too easily. In theory, he can do damage. Has a billion freaking damage. Yeah, probably he can. Still, if MiTH played this smart, if they played safe, they could split push, they can farm. And if they get big enough, they should be in decent shape. Queen of Pain can build that Hex later on. For Orange, Bounty Hunter shouldn't be a big factor in the team fights. Right now, he's giving them a lot of track gold. The track move speed is very helpful for TA, but eventually he's a hero who will just melt to the lifesteal. If he gets, say, Rubick lifted and open wounds, he should just die. Just flat out explode. Lekkels lurking top lane, has the illusions ready. They can't defend this tower. They have the Naga sleep as well, and for Orange, they have the one BKB on Mushi, but everyone else will be put to sleep. And if Mushi uses the BKB at the wrong time, it could actually work against him, because you can just net... Oh my goodness. Goes in onto four heroes and throws away his own life. Mushi saying, where's my team? They only got the Lashrak with that. I just didn't expect Mushi to go in there. What a ridiculous dive from him. Gets a kill, but it's only a support. Will that cost him? Lekkels, if he pops the sleep here, could maybe look to catch off the retreating forces. He's going to catch KYXY. This is going to be two cores down for Orange. This is a Song of the Siren expended. They don't catch anyone else, but KYXY will die. Not before he takes Abba with him. Walks right next to him. Throws away his own life. Just some really interesting and unusual aggression from both teams. Mushi just jumping in behind enemy lines into the middle of the entire enemy team. Thought he was invincible because he has BKB, then met the MKB Lifestealer. Apparently the Monkey King Bar is the strongest King Bar in the game. Or at least stronger than the Black King Bar. Now the Heart. Potentially on the way. He's up to 3,800 gold. Could go back for something like a Mantis style, which does obviously remove track. It's not a bad item, but I think at this point, you just want to tank up as much as possible. Just improve your split push. Make it harder for Orange to bring down your illusions. They have the Mushi Splash coming from the side blades. That's pretty good at killing off illusions, but they don't have much AoE aside from that. Radiance Burn is irrelevant against a Heart of Tarrasque. Naga, and it looks like that's what he's going for. He has the recipe up now, so it will be that Heart of Tarrasque. For anybody just tuning in, this is the Dotatalk League. I see we've slowly been accumulating some viewers. Thank you all for joining us here. We had some issues with the stream as well as the games getting played earlier. MEFC was forced to forfeit versus Orange because they couldn't get five and they did not want to use a stand-in today. So Orange, they got a forfeit win and now we're in a best out of one semifinal. The winner moves on to play the winner of the other semifinal, which I believe Gods is casting now. It's Zenith versus somebody. I don't actually know who the other team is. I'm sure someone in the chat can inform you right now, but here comes a smoke gank from Abba. He has this Ghost Scepter, a really nice choice because Mushi is the one who's going to kill you off. Nobody else is really a threat. Abba could blink in, but he could get insta-hexed here. They're lurking. They're waiting. They have the Observer on the other side. They're going to start with the Hex on Abba, but out comes TNK. Kills off the Shadow Shaman. No, doesn't actually get the kill. The Ghost Scepter keeping Abba alive, so Mushi can't do the damage. Now they get the Shadow Demon. Mushi BKB wearing off is going to be in a world of trouble in a few seconds time. The BKB is down. He's got to run. Meanwhile, Lekkels just farming on his own. Mushi wants to man back up, wants to kill off Abba, but simply blinks away. Now the Silence, now the Hex, stolen by SD. That is a big spell to steal. Mushi disrupted. Queen of Pain ult thrown in, does absolutely nothing. Ohio getting picked off. Where is Lekkels? They're forcing the fight. The ping's actually going top, but in the end, they do get the Bounty and the Shadow Shaman. They only lose the Rubick. Is that right? I thought they... Yeah, I guess it just was the Rubick. Looked like a decent fight for Orange because they had this Observer Ward here. But with the gem on MiTH, I believe that was dewarded after the fact. So no more vision for them. They even had the jump with the Hex and the Queen of Pain, but that Ghost Scepter saved her. Just unable And then, of course, the Hex was stolen by the Rubick and completely turned the fight. You see, once that BKB wears off for Mushi, there's just nothing he can do in these fights. And that's without the Naga being there. That's without the Radiance burn damage from removing your refraction. And it's also without the Ensnare being in play, obviously, which is going to make Mushi very vulnerable in these clashes. Lakel's with the hard up. What will we see next? Manta, Butterfly, the two likely candidates. Diffusal Blade is an option as well. Is actually pretty good as you can purge track off of yourself. But he really shouldn't be that worried about getting tracked. If you're Lakel's at this point in the game, you already have Mirror Image to remove track, so it's not really essential, and you should be fighting. You've been farming all game. You're up to 15k net worth. Myth Trust is getting to that point. A couple more big items. The Basher on the Lifestealer. Maybe something like an Assault Caress on him or Lakel's. Probably on the Lifestealer. And then you go look to Clash. I mean, then how are you going to actually win if you're Orange? Your Lone Druid does have AC, but still no Boots on his Bear. Yeah, Boots are pretty freaking good on your Lone Druid Bear. Because you already have Rabid, and the Bear is really strong base move speed. But not choosing to go for it. Could have basically max with the Rabid active. But says no, I'd rather be a little slower today. I want to enjoy the scenery. This bear is just out on a tour. Ohio's bus tours, or bear tours. Abba, Ghost Scepter out, BKB coming next. The Ghost Scepter is a really clutch item. I mean, you saw the power of it there. And Orange, in theory, I mean, even if you look at Lone Druid, he's also physical damage. So between TA and Lone Druid, there's just no way to pop the Screen of Pain unless you Hex her so she can't Ghost Scepter out. But with proper play, that's going to be unlikely. And the issue is also, you can't just Hex the Queen of Pain. You've got to be worried about the Lifestealer. And eventually, you're going to have to be really worried about this Lakel's Naga, which doesn't hit that hard, but once you get, say, a Butterfly, then the Naga really starts to hurt. Mithras roaming back towards the middle lane. Could look to push this tier 2. They should have the level 60 on Naga. Indeed, they do. So now Lakel's has the 1 minute cooldown. GG ultimate. You have your BKB? No problem. I will net you. I will sleep the rest of your team. And then we'll fight in a minute when your BKB is still cooling down.
Invisibility.
Queen of Pain with the Invis rune up. And also the other issue is, of course, that Mushi's BKB is losing charges. Down to 8 seconds, still pretty decent. But once you get to like that 7-6-5 range, then your BKB may wear off right when you're about to kill a hero. And then all of a sudden lifted, then all of a sudden potentially hexed or just split earth and brought down fairly quickly. So SD's level 11 has not gotten a chance to level up Nullfield, but this isn't really a game where you need to. He could honestly just get stats, because there's so much physical damage as Lakel's continues to pressure the bottom lane. There's just no... I don't know if Orange can even burst him. Mushi's going to need something like a Daedalus to bring him down, but he's gone for the Manta style. Wants to be able to remove that open wounds, wants just a few extra illusions to sow chaos in the fights, hopefully so he doesn't get telekinesis lifted or netted by the Naga. SD could look to push in this middle lane. Basher up on the lifestealer. They're getting the core items. Myth is smelling that victory. It is getting closer and closer. And if you're Orange, it's hard to leave the base right now. Lakel's is at that point where the illusions just take forever to kill. Even Ohio, mauling away on them takes quite a while. The bear is bottom, but Myth can deal with this bear. Obviously, when the hero's not there, it's not auto-attacking. Radiant's Burn isn't that scary at this point in the game. So it can split push, but Naga can more than counter that. Plus, she can farm your jungle at the same time. I think if you're Orange, Mushi just, he needs a massive damage item. Daedalus possibility, maybe even something like a Divine. Because they got to be able to burst Lakel's down before he can pop Son of the Siren. Or realistically, Mushi's just going to be netted and there's going to be sleep on everyone else, even if Myth is in trouble. Shadow Shaman, still no Blink. That's another big item that Orange could really use, is Extinct. Getting that Blink Dagger, so they have the reliable Blink Hex, which right now they don't. Queen of Pain is the BKB. Now we're going to see a Scythe Device next for Abba. No reason to go for anything else. And if he can get that, this is going to be a lot of trouble for Orange. With a blink Hex on their side and a Blink Orchid available as well. Plus the Lifestealer able to just instantly join the fights. Your back lines will just vanish in a matter of seconds. It'll be scratch your head. I thought we had a Shadow Shaman. Apparently I was wrong. Oh, how wrong you were. Lakel's continues to push top lane. If they can get a Hex on him, it might be an opening. They have a gem up right now. They could look to smoke by net. They're not going to doing so yet. Lakel's is going to start running, but KOXY is here. There's no mirror image, so he cannot remove track. They're going to start with the Janata, but just simply pops the sleep. And is he gonna TP out, or are they gonna fight? He TPs out. It was a bit late. But he'll be okay. That was close, though. He tried to stall as much as possible. The reason being, they're doing Roche, but Mushi's here. Can he have that miraculous fight where he just cleaves through the way through three heroes? Not gonna happen. MiTH are playing a little bit safer now. Mushi does some good damage, though, but if he gets bashed, it's gonna be bad news bears. Orange want to Rosh right now because they know that that Song of the Siren is on cooldown. It's not going to be up in time for this Rosh. Rosh is dropping quickly. Orange may be able to sneak or pull a fast one. R5, R5 jumps in. Leicester Bomb comes out. They go onto the Bounty Hunter. No bashes yet. TNK is probably cursing right now. Where the hell are my bashes? He says he's not getting them. KY, XY on the run. The E just picked up by Mushi, who's now on the chase. He wants some kills. He goes with the Melcrit. Doesn't find the kill on the Queen of Pain, but will pick off that Lashrak. Now Laquelle's in the middle of the fight, has the song in 8 seconds, still diving, but being burst down fairly quickly. TNK rejoins the fight, open wounds. Did he actually get Mushi? I don't think he did, but Mushi, BKB now deployed. Lone Druid will fall, Gem on the floor, absolute chaos. Man fight, Lifestealer versus TA, but unfortunately the Lifestealer was hitting creeps there. Gem will die, Mushi still has Aegis, and every time there's a Rosh fight, it's just Orange destroying the fights. They're down by 8,000 gold, which isn't that much, but they're still down. They don't really have the better hard carries late game. And Mushi just in the right place at the right time. MiTH getting caught, but the big thing there was no Naga Sleep. Laquelle's used it to TP away top, and unfortunately, Orange just played it really smart and went straight towards the pit. Okay, KYXY is looking to dive SD. If he gets a range for that Janata crit in time, this will be a kill, but he's not, so he will back off. Mushi is gonna have that next item. Come on, Mushi, get that divine. Your fans insist, your fans demand it. You must do so. It'll probably be, I mean, it could be an MKB if he's worried about the Naga going for the butterfly, but Naga has already shown that she is a manta at this point, as her illusions are in the lane now. So Daedalus might be the better choice. We'll have to see. Of course, they do have a Hex, so the evasion isn't necessarily the biggest concern in the world. Mushi now pretty much neck and neck. And this is your classic RNG sports. This is what we're used to seeing for Mushi, which is playing a solo mid, but playing it as a hard carry. I called Ohio the one position, but it's really Mushi who is playing like the one position right now. He's been farming a lot. He's been getting a lot of kills. He has not been dying that much since the early game. The Lone Druid, not so lucky. Ohio 4-6, but Mushi 9-4, shouldering the heavy load. Orange just keep on having the superior fights, and as a result, pulling ahead a bit. There's also no Hex on Abba. Normally, 40 minutes in, your Queen of Pain would be looking at a Hex, but went for the BKB and the Ghost Scepter and the Orchid. Three fairly expensive mid-game items. And it has delayed that Hex as a result, but I assume the Scythe Device will come next. Laquelle's Manta up. There's really nothing else to do now except Butterfly. You can maybe go Diffusal Blade, you can maybe go Boots of Travel, but realistically, they need a bit more damage. Hex starts on Abba, but a Wild Lifestealer appears. There's your Disruption. Now a Bash on KYXY, not dead just yet. The Purge comes out. They're focusing TNK, who already used Disinfest to start the fight. He will explode in a cloud, a Hailstorm of Pain. He'll buy back immediately. He's gonna look to fight the TP out from Lashrak. Can Mushi burst him down? He can. He will. He gets the kill with that Daedalus online. He did use a drum charge there. His final one of the game. Laquelle's forcing the push back top, but MiTH Trust once again fighting without the Naga. They just keep on taking fights without their primary teamfight hero, their primary teamfight carry. And when it's a smaller scale engagement, that's where Orange really shines, because they have Disruption and they have Demonic Purge and they have Hex. Some of the best abilities in the game in 3-on-3, 4-on-4, so mid to small sized engagements. It's the bread and butter of these supports, and it's the bread and butter of a TA. And Mushi right now, playing like a boss. But not really having himself tested because of the way MiTH is constructing these fights. Forcing engagements when they don't have their big team play here. We'll see if they look to change things, but after all these fights going Orange's way, it feels like it's Orange's game. They've got that Aegis up now. MiTH, they're not broken the base yet, and it feels like they don't actually know how to win this game. They knew how to farm, they knew how to get Laquelle's big, they knew how to get an advantage, but you gotta know how to end the game. And two awful engagements at Rosh, a third awful engagement outside of the Rosh pit in the mid lane, and still no answer for Mushi, who is now approaching, not max farm, but getting close. He can get one more big item, and then, you know, if he doesn't have that Aegis, potentially two more, and then the Boots of Travel, and that's pretty much it. So he's getting close. He's got 2,500 gold. He's about halfway towards that first of the two potential huge items coming out. And I'm starting to worry for MiTH Trust. It looked like they were in solid position with the Mass Ghost Scepters on the course here and no Diffusal Blade on Orange, so no way to actually remove that Ghost Form. But you gotta close the deal. Can they do it, guys? I don't know. Getting a little nervous here. This is a crucial game for Orange, I feel, just from a team morale standpoint, because they lost to MUFC in the GST Dota 2 stages. Or grand finals for February, and you know, we saw them struggle a bit yesterday, dropping that game to First Departure. And it wasn't the fact that they lost. First Departure is a good team, but it's the way that they lost, where it seemed like the team communication and decision making just was very poor. And that's the kind of game, if you're a pro team, if you're a really good individual, if you have really good individual skills, where you're gonna get frustrated and upset and basically say, come on guys, we're a lot better than this. What the hell were we doing in that game? This may have been one prompted Mushi to say, I'm gonna go TA, I'm gonna play mid. We're not doing our Luna Chen five-man strats anymore. At least not for this game. But MiTH Trust not out of it yet by any means. Sight Device and the Creed of Pain would be a big pickup. Mushi's lurking with the Daedalus. Look at that crit. Look at that crit. That's a lot of damage. Drops the trap. Not going yet. Doesn't have that Bleak Dagger, so can't just instantly jump in, of course. Normally when you pick a hero like the Naga Siren, she's not your one position. That's the interesting thing about the way that MiTH Trust plays this hero. At the International 2, there was an interview that Team Liquid did with Xiaowei, and he basically said that the Chinese teams do not view Naga as a one position. She's a two position. She's a great teamfight initiator. She scales well with items, but she's not a hard carry. You look at her abilities, and she's not. She used to have Critical Strike instead of this Riptide, so she scaled a lot better, but she doesn't have that innate steroid on her hero anymore. And the later the game goes, she does start to sort of tail off a little bit. Which is why when your team picks Naga, you expect her to join the fights, but that hasn't really been the case. I think we've seen Naga in one or two actual head-on clashes. Aside from that, Lakels has just been playing the way he plays, which is split pushing and farming. Unfortunately, when you run that kind of style, your team has to execute flawlessly, and sometimes you do need to join the fights. You can't just live on an island the entire game. And a combination of the team being out of position, forcing fights they shouldn't, and Lakels not arriving when he should, has put them in a bit of a pickle here. Very slow paces where it hit the 45-minute mark. Only looking at 45 kills. Yesterday, we had like 2 kills a minute in a 40-minute game. Today, we're looking at, well, barely 1 a minute. And Mushi's on the hunt. He wants to go from Lakels. Remember, he's got the BKB and the Manta. The Song is going to be used. Lakels could just TP out now. Should be able to get away just fine. And he will, but Song's on cooldown. Of course, there's no Rosh up yet, but it's coming soon. Something that Lakels will need to be careful about. They cannot get caught without that Song of the Siren in another big clash. Scythe of Ice slowly being built by Abba. This is the way they can kill TA. If they get that Hex on her off the bat, Mushi up to 4.4k. Oh boy, what's he going to go for now? Will he go for some more damage? Is he going to go back for survivability? I don't really think he needs more damage. I'd like to see something like an Assault Kurath. Or not Assault Kurath, because Lundred already has one. They're going to start with the net here. Lakels is kind of manning up. Gets tracked. Has Manson to remove it. Did go back for Boots of Travel. So still no more big items. But after the Boots of Travel, you got to imagine, beyond buyback, he's saving for something that'll actually allow him to contribute more in the fights. He's not the only damage dealer. But the amount of farm they're giving him, you'd think he was. And you can see the one downside to having Lakels as the one is, well, it gets hard for the rest of your team to farm. TNK had these items like a good 10 minutes ago. No real progression since then. It's been hard to find space to farm. Queen of Pain has found some, but the Lifesteal are just not as mobile as those Naga Illusions collectively or as the Queen of Pain individually. Are they going to go for an Infest gank again? They have the Scythe Device by Abba. Has not been spotted by any wards just yet. Gem up. A fresh gem for Abba and a Scythe Device. If there were ever a time to go for a gank, it would be now. Abba's going to pick up an Invis in bottom. There is a trap here, but this only provides the most minimal of vision. You have to be looking basically right here on the minimap, or you're not going to see that Queen of Pain jumping in. And let's see if they can actually predict where she's going to go. Lone Druid, any progression on him? Just a Ghost Scepter up to 4.2k. 4.1k. And Mushi up to 5.6k. Will he think towards the Heart of Tarrasque? Will he think towards the Divine? Even something like a butterfly could be quite decent. Well, or just don't even buy items, because clearly you don't need them. One crit, the entire creep wave that is splashed dies instantly. That'll do the trick. Naga Illusions pressuring that top lane. Laquelle's looking to TP out. Oh, he might get caught. He just used Mirror Image. He used Manta. He can be tracked. He can be burst down. He's got the Sawn. The pause demanded, but Laquelle's is scrambling. He's on the run. Oh, no. Laquelle's could be dead here. Extinct almost in range for that Hex. In fact, he might just be. And if they get this Hex, Laquelle's will die. Does he have buyback? That's the question now. Oh boy, this is a big moment. He's got to pop the Sawn instantly, but if you're Mushi, you're Poppy, you're BKB right away. The question is, can they burst him down, or can they Hex him? Laquelle's no Sawn yet, now gets Hexed. Was just in range, Laquelle's will die. An absolutely devastating death, but immediately a buyback. They dive in top, they want to go on the Sawn Druid. Ohio can go down, but he doesn't buyback. Even if they kill him off, he gets disrupted, he's still alive. How about Ghost Scepters, so he can't be damaged. Well, inside of Entangle, they're forced to TP away on the back lines of Zesty, trying to run, but tracked up by KOX. Well, he cannot TP because he'll simply get Shuriken tossed into submission, and the chase is on. Gem hits the deck. Meanwhile, KOX completes the kill, as expected. And now, Orange, what do you know? It's Roche time. MiTH Trust just completely falling apart in this game. Maybe it was lag on Laquelle's there, but it was very slow. Generally, when you see that TA, you just instantly saw him so you can actually sleep her before she has a chance to BKB, but just a split second late. Maybe the lag at play, maybe just slow on the fingers. Not entirely sure, and it cost them. It really hurts. Laquelle's is up again. He does have evasion. But you can see, Naga's a hero that you can burst easily. Especially with that Hex, the evasion not going to do anything for you there. And now they're pushing mid. Aegis up on Mushi again, up to 7k. Where's my Divine, Mushi? I'm awaiting. They do have a Ghost Scepter, but this will only delay the inevitable. The down he will go. Who's going to get the kill? It'll be Mushi. Who am I kidding? It's always Mushi when he's playing this TA. Getting the kills all over the place. And MiTH Trust really was in a solid position this game, but it looks like they may just be done. Queen of Pain also still dead. Got picked up by the Shadow Demon earlier, and the racks are gonna just melt with all the damage on the bear. Now sitting on an additional Demon Edge. Mushi's brought, gotta be thinking towards the Divine Rapier. MiTH Trust, TNK on the run. One lane of racks down. Orange will TP back. It's actually a base race being attempted, but the Naga Illusions are dying fairly quickly. Shadow Demon Illusions on the Naga's own, and the racks will live. So an uncontested base here. TNK manning up, bashing Mushi, trying to bring him down. He's dropping low. He will fall. He does have Aegis. He comes back soon. There's your bash on KYXY. Laquelle's still alive. Has used everything, though. Now the Hex. Mushi held in place by the Shackle, though stolen by SD. They go back to work. They're trying to bring him down. He's still alive. That damn refraction. He will fall, but he can just buy back immediately. I expect he'll do so. There you go. No hesitation. KYXY to fall. MiTH getting a bunch of kills on the way out here as Extinct tries to escape. If anybody else gets caught without buyback, potentially they could go for some racks of their own. Look, Extinct will drop. Extinct is dead. Does not have buy... Actually, oh, he does. So everybody's going to be up, aside from the Bounty Hunter. So MiTH, when it's all said and done, they basically trade racks for a tier 3 and a few kills. But the game seems to be heading towards Orange. And now Mushi says, MKB for me. No Divine. No Rapier. Too rich for his blood. A man can dream, though, guys. A man can dream. ...50 minutes in, this game starting to get towards that ultra late game. We look 10-15 minutes in the future, and it pretty much will be there. I'd say probably, like, less than 2% of Dota games even gets to the 50-minute mark. It's gotta be a very small number. That's just my guess, though. As they're hunting the enemy jungle. Remember, they also lost the gem in that last fight. There's a Abyssal up on Lifestealer. I think he had it in the last engagement, and that's a big item to have against Mushi. Remember, if Mushi dies, he won't have buyback. He doesn't have Aegis right now. Traps are deployed. Tower taking some chip damage. No commitment just yet. They could try and swing around to this top Rex. I wonder if they'll think about sending the Naga Illusions there at least. Could look to do so, and there won't be that backdoor protection as the tier 3 is down. There's a TP to top lane, though. Creed of Pain's going to back off. And without Creed of Pain, they all need to run, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Laquelle's will head bottom. Queen of Pain will head top. And Laquelle's is getting closer to that butterfly. In fact, he's got it now with the Eagle Horn as well as the quarterstaff. I wonder if he'll purchase it. If he does, he won't buy back up to 500 gold. And yet it doesn't... Or 500 CS, I should say. 500 gold. Yeah, 25k net worth, but... We're seeing that he's just not contributing the way that Mushi is. And it's just the weakness of that hero At this point of the game, Mushi's on the hunt. If he catches R5, R5, R5 is dead. Trap to start. Ghost Scepter is up. Can he look to go? A nice lift from the Rubick. Gonna end the aggression. Gonna allow him to escape safely. And a big no. Not gonna allow him to escape safely. And in fact, it may be R5, R5 who dies, but the Song of the Siren comes out. Oh no, they're not gonna have this for a minute. Will they look to fight now? They can start with the Abyssal on Mushi. Are they gonna do so? There's a Hex. Now just burst down. He doesn't have buyback. Mushi is dead. Can they win without Mushi? That's the question. The net on KYXY under the tower, dropping low. Everyone alive for MiTH. A great fight going their way. Now the TP ought to be attempted by Ohio, who will escape. Can they just barrel down mid? Maybe they just head towards top, frantically try to get this Rax down while the backdoor protection is unavailable. Let's see what they do. They have 70 seconds of no Mushi. The tides have turned again. The butterfly is now out for the Naga. She's up to 5k. Lekkels is heading top. He wants to push this top lane in. Mushi won't be up for a minute. It's going to be close. I think they're going to have like 10, 15 seconds to wail away on the Rex, and that should be enough to bring it down. Well, let's find out exactly how long they have. And actually, Bounty Hunter, no buyback on him either. This is going to be, it should be at least one lane of Rex without the glyph. There just isn't going to be a way to defend it. Let's see, though. If Orange lose any more heroes during this engagement, that could easily be game. Whereas for MiTH, do they have buyback? That's the question now for them. Lifestealer does. None of the other cores really do, though. And they're going to just chip away at the Rax. The Rax will fall. They want to go for two here, potentially even more than I thought. More like 30 seconds. So this could be game. MiTH may just win because Mushi didn't have buyback because he lost the Aegis in the previous fight. That's going to be two lanes of Rax. And they have the better split pushing lineup. Two lanes, maybe even three, as the Illusions head towards bottom. They'll probably back off after this. Just kidding. No, they won't. Lekkels is here. MiTH Trust probably just going to win this one on the back of one fight. One death for Mushi. This game started with a four hero gank on Mushi, and it ends with Mushi not having buyback, potentially. Here we go. Extinct Hexed up, dropping quickly. Ghost Scepter's his way, trying to survive. TNK will fall, but he should have buyback. He does. He can come back. There's your Naga ult. Will they TP out? Going for the TP right now as R5 is going to escape on the fringes of that. Meanwhile, on the base, the creeps are here, but that's okay. The Naga Illusions finding some additional kills on the Shadow Shaman, who will buy back, but the damage is done, guys, and MiTH Trust have pulled this one back. It looks to be their game. It's got to be all in desperation. Some sort of throne race, some sort of big base gank if you're Orange, and the issue is going to be Naga has buyback with Song of the Siren, and she also has Butterfly and Heart. Butterfly, Heart, Manta, good luck killing her twice before that Song of the Siren has a chance to cool down. And even just one usage can ruin the fight. They have the cheese on Mushi now, handed over to him from Ohio, I do believe. And now they're going to push in mid. But they don't have their whole team here. They've got to wait. And while they're waiting, the creeps are pushing bottom. The creeps are going to push top. And the song could come at any moment. Let's see if it's going to go. Lekkels circling around. Big army of illusions. Open woods on Mushi. Abyssal is here. Will it be used? The BKB reveals him, but it's actually TK. He's going to die first. Oh, no. Just kidding. No, he won't. Infest inside his team. He's alive. Lashrak is going to die on the back lines. No, he doesn't. KYXY can't finish the kill. Lekkels will song. Lekkels will stall. The BKB for Mushi is down. He can try and fight. He knows he's got to win this engagement now, but the issue is with no BKB, well, he's pretty much down to this cheese. That's going to be it. They're going for the throne. Orange is going all in. But there is a glyph. I don't know if they can actually do this. They're trying though, damn it. They're gonna try their little hearts out. Queen of Pain almost brings Mushi down. He doesn't have refraction. He pops it just in the nick of time. The towers are dropping. MiTH got a fight suit. They lose a tier 4, but they haven't lost the fight yet. In comes Lekkels. Riptide on 4. Two die in a matter of seconds. Now Ohio. And while that's all happening, the Dire Throne dies to the creeps that I pointed out earlier. Bottom and top lanes. What a ridiculous finish to a very slow game. Oh my goodness, Orange Esports, they pulled it all the way back, and then they throw it all away. Mushi, that crucial death, played so well through the mid-game, but we just saw that once that TA BKB wears off, she is total food, and Aegis not really that effective on her at this point in the game. Guys, thank you all for tuning in. You are watching the Dota Talk League. We have more action coming up next. It will be your grand finals, and I think for that one, I should have someone to cast with me so my voice is preserved, as I believe we're going to have 4 events this weekend. More on that later. But for now, stay tuned. The Dota Talk grand finals await, and MiTH Trust pull a fast one. Orange, they will be advancing in to that best of 3 to face the winner of Zenith and whoever the hell Zenith is playing. I'm LD. If you join my casting, be sure to follow me. Twitter.com/LDDota. And stay tuned, because more Dota Talk League action is coming up after this.